Welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Going to be speaking with Mr. Antony Koblish this morning, co-founder and CEO of TELA Bio. He's joining us on the program to talk about OviTex. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Mr. Antony Koblish, and thanks for taking the time.
Hey, thanks, Neil. I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you today.
Now, I do understand that you're a medical device entrepreneur. You've got quite a few years of experience under your belt in that area. Give us a little look into your area of expertise, and then let's talk about the mission of TELA Bio.
Sure. So, I've been fortunate in my career over the last 20, 25 years to be able to put together several different companies and have the pleasure of working with great teams to help build them up. One common theme for all of those companies is to find a mission, as you say, that we felt like was being underserved by the big companies. You know, sometimes big corporations, they get locked in to a certain way of doing things. And as a company gets bigger and bigger, innovation can often take a back seat. This is quite common in the medical device arena. A lot of times, small startup companies driven by, you know, smart leadership teams, engineers and medical doctors step up to see these openings and these needs for improved patient care and improved tools for surgeons. And small companies step up. And we really try with our team to focus on those unmet needs. And TELA Bio is a superb example of that. We put the team together in 2012 and 2013, attracted really blue chip investors to the company and a very strong team of medical doctors, engineers, and PhDs, scientists, to tackle the problem of soft tissue reconstruction. Hernia repair typically uses 50-year-old plastic mesh. At the time when we were setting the company up, plastic mesh was under siege in the OBGYN arena. Mm-hmm. A lot of failures, a lot of contraction, a lot of erosion. And we thought that these were the same exact products that were being used in hernia repair quite a bit more often. And we figured that we should look for a better solution. So that's really the connection there.
This better solution, as opposed to this 50-year-old technology that you were talking about, and you are right, it's plagued with problems, under siege, I guess, would be the correct term for it. I mean, we're seeing all of these advertisements about hernia mesh lawsuits. There are thousands of them that are going on as we speak.
Yeah, that's right. I think there's probably an aggregate of 30,000 or more cases aggregated in class action. It seemed to us at the time when we set up TELA Bio that this was going to happen. It wasn't happening at the time, but to us it seemed like it was going to be an extension and a repeat of what happened in the OBGYN. You know, plastic mesh that's permanent is plastic mesh that's permanent. It's the same product that's used in both applications. And the mechanism of action of failure is a foreign body reaction. Plastic is not a natural repair solution, and often the body will respond to a foreign body by contracting, reject it, and create inflammation. When that happens, there's things like erosion and problems that can happen. And for whatever reason, we didn't fully understand that this problem seems to be tolerated in hernia. Because it happens later after the surgery. It can happen 5 years, 10 years later. It can happen even sooner. But there's just an awful lot of plastic mesh removed from patients, and we thought we could do better. And so we developed a solution that we call a natural repair, hashtag go natural. And what we've done is we've minimized the dose of any permanent material. We put a very small amount of suture material, commonly used in sewing up wounds, and sew it into our biological matrices that we've developed. So these biological matrices are very soft. They tend to integrate with the patient's body and remodel into the patient's own tissue. And then we use these suture materials, just a very small, light reinforcement of suture material, to create almost a rebar reinforcement like you'd find in concrete. So there's not enough material, permanent material there to cause an inflammation and foreign body reaction and problems, potential problems. But it's just enough to reinforce in case that biological material isn't enough to hold. And, you know, these are really composite engineered materials. It's new technology. We've been on the market since about 2017. We've got 12 or 13,000 procedures done. And our early clinical data with 1 year and 2 year follow up from our Bravo study so far has been superb. The recurrence rate, the reason to go back in for additional surgery has been exceptionally low, very low, low, low single digits, one maybe across the first 50 some odd patients at 12 months and no recurrences so far in patients that have been followed up for 2 years so far. So we're going to continue to read that data out, but the early signals look really strong. And we think we've, you know, we focused on trying to solve this problem for patients and surgeons by creating a new implant. First one in 50 years, really. So we're pleased.
I envision that the body grows around this mesh and basically uses it to reinforce its own healing as this material gets absorbed into the soft tissue. Is that a fair assessment of what's happening?
Yeah, man. Neil, that's close. Absolutely. So, you know, the biological material that we use is actually comes from New Zealand, and it's made from the first stomach of sheep. So very, very thin sheets of biological material that are cleaned up. They're decellularized. And we do that in a way that leaves a lot of the macromolecules and signaling factors in place to attract cellular content into the matrix. And, you know, I think you have to think about these biological materials almost from a tissue engineering perspective, where we're encouraging and attracting cells into the matrix. And then those cells do their thing, right? They slowly differentiate, turn into fibroblasts, and eventually, you know, we'll make a collagen-like, fascia-like material. And there's a creeping substitution where the biological material is slowly turning over into the patient's natural tissue. We've proven that in a very extensive non-human primate study that's been published in the journal Hernia. We've done well over 200 cases to track the speed of turnover of tissue. And what's really interesting is that our material tends to heal very efficiently and remodel. But if there's any kind of deficit or weakness in the patient's natural tissues, our suture material that reinforces that biologic, again, like rebar and concrete, can pick up the slack. It can hold the load and hold everything together. And so far, like I said, our recurrence rate, the reason to remove a mesh, even the pain and stiffness that you feel that's typical with a plastic mesh, all seem to not be a problem with our material. So, you know, we think we have something special. We're going to continue to study it. We're going to continue to develop proof that this is a strong material. And we think it's a premier material to be used robotically, which is very minimally invasively. And it's a premier material for safety if you're worried about a permanent plastic mesh causing harm in the future.
Traditionally, were there ever any compounds, drugs used to alleviate some of the symptoms associated with the plastic mesh, that foreign material? And if so, are those same compounds necessary using OviTex in some circumstances?
Well, that's an interesting question. I can't really think of any other than, you know, the routine use of antibiotics in case of infection or in prophylactically preventing an infection. And, you know, that is a fairly serious adverse event that can happen in hernia surgery. I believe it's infrequent, but it can happen. And certainly if you have a permanent plastic mesh in your body, you're quite sensitive to any type of infection. Once a permanent material does get infected, it can be problematic, and sometimes you know, that product has to be removed if it can't be treated through antibiotics. you know, with our material, with our products, they tend to be more resistant in the face of contamination or infection because there's a biological mechanism of action going on there. And if you can get cells in there that can drive tissue remodeling, you can get cells into the matrix that will, you know, help combat infection, perhaps. And since we have a very, very small, minimal amount of suture material in there that's really no different from sewing up a wound, that small amount of material is less susceptible to harboring an infection. So, you know, one of the themes, Neil, that we use to develop our OviTex Go Natural platform of products is to make it so that the surgeon is comfortable using our product without changing their technique. And we've worked very closely with surgeons on this. We've worked with well over 100 surgeons in developing the product and the techniques associated with the product. And what became evident to us is let's just keep the techniques the same, right? I mean, it's very easy to use permanent plastic mesh. So let's just make it so that there's no adjustments or techniques to learn, and surgeons can benefit from all the experience they have, and hopefully, you know, just swap the material from a permanent plastic material, old 50-year-old technology, to these hybrid composite materials, such as what TELA Bio develops.
Where can our listeners get some more information about TELA Bio online?
Yeah, we have a great website. We're on all social media platforms. Hashtag Go Natural may tag to something. Certainly, OviTex is searchable, and we encourage you to check out our surgeon finder on our website. There are many, many great surgeons that have worked with us and helped us develop these rebar reinforced materials, and we believe that we're in the early stages of hopefully a paradigm shift away from permanent plastic and towards these natural repair solutions that can be used robotically and open. And our goal is to make TELA Bio the leader in that arena. And we encourage everybody to check out our website, look us up on all social media. And if you do have a hernia consult required, please take a look at our surgeon finder if you have any interest at all in our Go Natural program. Thank you.
And that website would be www.telabio.com, TELABIO.com.
That's right. Thanks, Neil.
Well, I appreciate you joining us here, Antony. It's been a pleasure.
All right. Pleasure, too. Have a good day, man.
You as well. You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neil Howard. Audio copies of this program are available at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au. You can also subscribe to the podcast on iTunes. Listen in, download it, SoundCloud, and be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/healthprofessionalradio.